Hi everyone, my name is Casey Jane Eslick. Today I'm presenting information related to my master's research. In this presentation, we will be discussing the importance of phonological awareness and speech perception and noise skills to improve English second language learners' classroom participation. This research was presented at the PULFA conference in 2019, as well as the University of Pretoria's Department of Speech Language Pathology and Audiology Research Day. The research has also been published in the journal Reading and Writing. To start with a bit of background, research recognizes literacy skills in South Africa are in a state of crisis. The Progress in International Reading Literacy Study shows literacy levels of South African learners are a concern, with 78% of grade 4 learners not having enough skills to be able to read and write correctly to learn, which gives us a big concern for their ability to matriculate. As we know, literacy skills impact employment opportunities and success later in life, which leads us to also having a concern for our economy. Research has identified that in order to develop literacy skills, children require sufficient language skills, working memory, and vocabulary knowledge. They also need a sufficient understanding of the speech sounds and abilities to relate these speech sounds to visual letters, which is known as phonological awareness. This means children need appropriate hearing abilities with, and this is the important part, sufficient exposure to the sounds of the language in which they will learn literacy skills. It gets harder for our children for two reasons in South Africa. Firstly, many learners don't speak the language of learning and teaching at home, so they have a lack of exposure to these speech sounds when they need to learn literacy. And secondly, as we know when we think about South African classrooms, well, they're not quiet, are they? When children enter school, their hearing and listening skills in the language of learning and teaching need to be good enough to understand words and hear speech sounds in noise. We acknowledge that there are other factors to consider from the home environment, like parents' literacy skills, socioeconomic status in general, access to libraries for books, and having a lack of an appropriate adult model in the language of learning and teaching to learn the language skills that children need. However, today we are focusing on why and how we can prioritize phonological awareness and speech perception and noise skills in the classroom, as these are foundations for literacy development. Children need phonological awareness in order to develop literacy. It is important to note that phonological awareness is one of the strongest predictors of literacy development. These skills for the awareness of speech sounds develop in a hierarchy, as shown in the table. They are the skills to identify, manipulate, and work with speech sounds to become aware of the sounds and then relate this awareness to visual representations or letters. Phonological awareness skills develop through hearing and listening to speech sounds from birth. Speech perception skills slowly develop and reach full development around the start of high school. Speech perception is necessary to associate phonemes or sounds with graphemes or letters, as our multilingual learners often lack language experience in their language of learning and teaching. They often don't have enough awareness of speech sounds to perceive them in speech, which reduces their phonological awareness and abilities to relate speech sounds to visual letters. With poor listening conditions in the classroom, we're left questioning, how is it fair that the second language learners are expected to acquire a language, phonological awareness skills, and develop literacy at the same time, while they also need to keep up pace to participate with first language learners in their classroom? To provide support to our multilingual or second language learners, we need to understand what level of skills they have. As a research project, we asked, what are the phonological awareness skills of English second language learners in comparison to English first language learners in the grade 1 classroom? We determined this by doing assessments using the phonological awareness test 2 from Robertson and Salter 2007 and the South African English Digits and Noise test. As phonological awareness is the strongest predictor of literacy success, it is concerning that results showed English second language learners' score, shown by the red columns, differs significantly from English first language learners' score, shown by the blue columns. These differences occurred by more than one standard deviation for all phonological awareness subtests. The research findings are also supported further by international research showing similar findings. Phonological awareness lays the foundation for literacy development. So how can we expect learners in grade 1 to gain literacy skills if they don't have phonological awareness? And what can we do to help? If you look at the first columns for rhyming, English second language learners had significant difficulty with rhyming, and more than 50% of English second language learners were unable to give their own rhyming word. We know that poor speech perception and reduced exposure to rhyming may impact their scores, as rhyming seldom exists in African languages, and when it does, most of the time, rhymes occur focusing on the beginning of a word, whereas in English, rhymes focus on the end of a word or even the end of a sentence. Rhyming is important to develop early listening and auditory memory skills, which supports awareness of syllables and later phonemes or sounds. Rhyming tasks and reciting of rhymes should therefore be included in a phonological awareness program in all South African classrooms. We then move on to the second column or columns for segmentation, where we see that English second language learners had a higher level of segmentation skills, and this can be attributed to their formal skill instruction in grade R, showing that intervention can be effective in our preschool years. The correct responses of English second language learners declined from sentence level to syllables, and then were less than half of those provided by first language learners in their phoneme or sounds level. This shows that English second language learners' phonological awareness develops according to the hierarchy: sentences, then syllables, and then a higher level of awareness of phonemes, just like English first language learners. This can be used when teaching phonological awareness in the classrooms, and English second language learners' success with syllables highlights that the syllable level is focused on well in preschool years. However, we need to do more explicit sound awareness to develop literacy and sound letter coupling for literacy. We then shift over to the second to last columns of substitution. Substitution requires a higher level of skills to combine phonological awareness and phoneme-grapheme knowledge for sound letter relations. However, many second language learners did not understand this task and showed greatest difficulty. The results support findings showing that English second language learners have greatest difficulty with sound awareness and for tasks requiring manipulation of sounds compared to forced choices like rhyming discrimination. Does this rhyme, yes or no? That is much easier for second language learners compared to substitution, where they need to manipulate and substitute sounds. This means that English second language learners have difficulty building new words and expanding their vocabulary, which can further the difference between them and English first language learners in a classroom. English second language learners' blending score is the last one we should talk about. A difference of 27 months was shown between English first and English second language learners' blending skills. On a positive note, blending skills of English second language learners on a syllable level is nearly sufficient. However, on a phoneme level, they require additional support. Integration of phonological awareness and phoneme-grapheme knowledge is vital to support development of literacy skills, which shows us that intervention for this vital. The effects of poor phonological awareness skills are shown by the significant difference between English first and second language learners' scores in the graphemes and decoding subtests. In the grapheme subtest, English second language learners scored 3 years below English first language participants. This may be attributed to reduced print exposure in their home environment, though it's important to note that English second language learners had the greatest difficulty producing vowel phonemes when shown the letters, which may be attributed to reduced number of vowels in their African languages. It shows that we do truly need to focus on listening and identifying sounds in the grade one classroom to support English second language learners' awareness, and we need to have a particular and focused attention on identifying vowel sounds, as English second language learners have difficulty with this, and vowels appear in every word in the English language, or almost every word for that matter. English second language learners' score for decoding was 2 years below English first language learners. The results supported that learners with poor phonological awareness are at risk for literacy difficulties. Explicit instruction in the grade one classroom is needed for better letter sound coupling to improve transfer of phonological awareness skills to literacy, and like we've said, in particular for vowel phonemes. When our multilingual learners arrive in the classroom, they don't have enough awareness of speech sounds, which makes learning literacy difficult. They are often trying to learn the speech sounds while they're trying to learn literacy skills. Our learners also need to hear these speech sounds through the classroom noise while a child is moving their pen or dropping their space case or scraping their chair or tapping their foot, or there's a car driving past outside, or there's a lawnmower, or there's wind, or a banging door. Children need to still listen through all of that noise and hear and learn speech sounds. With average class sizes of 45 learners in South Africa, we increase the distance between teachers and learners without realizing. Increasing the distance increases reverberation, which can make the speech signal less clear as well, making it harder for children to hear their speech sounds. While children are doing this, and all of this, and how much of what I just said did you hear? While children are making a noise, the other children around them are trying to listen to speech sounds, and this is really difficult. In our research, we therefore explored what the speech perception and noise skills are of English second language learners in comparison to their English first language peers. In this graph, you should note that a more negative score indicates better speech perception and noise skills, as sounds are heard in a higher level of background noise. Our results showed that there is a significant difference between the English first language and English second language learners. The difference was 1.4 decibels, which clinically is not really significant. However, our results are based on perception of digits, which is a closed set of information to hear in noise, and it's also something that English second language learners are fairly familiar with because many African languages use English digits, and learners have learned to count during grade R using English digits. This makes them easier to identify. However, international research has shown a difference between English first and English second language learners' abilities to hear in noise as well, and their difference is based on sentence and noise perception, which is highly relevant to the function of listening and noise in the classroom. And this difference is shown to be greater than the 1.4 decibels that was obtained in this research, showing that overall, English second language learners do require a higher signal-to-noise ratio to benefit from linguistic information, and this does place them at a long-term disadvantage in their learning environment. In South Africa, we are a multilingual, diverse nation, and we celebrate this. However, this does present a few challenges in terms of the educational system, because we speak so many languages nationally. However, English and Afrikaans are used as the primary languages of learning and teaching throughout the country. Even though just 23% of South Africans identify with English and Afrikaans as their home languages. Approximately 65% of learners are enrolled in English schools, although only about 10% of the South African population speaks English. This means we have the challenge where many learners have a home language that differs from their language of learning and teaching in the classroom. When these children enter school, they lack experience to learn the vocabulary and the speech sounds required to develop literacy. So we then need to ask, what phonological awareness and speech perception skills do they have, and how can we help? Because phonological awareness and speech perception are extremely important for literacy. We now have a good idea based on our research that they do have a difference in their phonological awareness and speech perception and noise skills. So we now need to work out what it is that we're going to do to support these learners. Moving forward, we need to make sure that our teachers are informed about the challenges that second language learners face when they're developing literacy skills. We need to make sure that they are equipped with knowledge of how to help these learners, and that means that we should form a transdisciplinary approach. We should involve speech therapists, audiologists, and the parents so that we can support teachers. Teachers are not alone. Speech therapists can inform them about challenges of learning in a second language and ways that we can prioritize speech sounds. Audiologists can share ideas about ways that we can adapt the classroom, such as closing windows and doors, possibly hanging curtains or putting in carpets, or even using like egg boxes underneath desks to try and help reduce the noise. There are many different strategies that we can use to try and support learners to listen in the classroom. And parents, most importantly, need to be supported so that they can support their children at home. We can teach parents how we are planning on teaching speech sounds. We can teach parents what the speech sounds are that the learners are learning about, and hopefully they can then continue that classroom teaching at home as well. Then, in the classroom, we should focus ourselves on maximizing listening and speech perception and noise skills. We should ensure children are listening with their whole bodies. Their ears should be turned on, their head and their eyes should face the teacher, their mouth should be quiet, their hands and feet should be still, and they should be sitting comfortably in their seats in order to really take in the information presented to them. Instead of fighting literacy as a battle with pens on paper, we should start with the ears and the mind. Before starting lessons in the classroom, we can help children to turn on their ears by playing listening games. Especially before we work on literacy and language tasks, this way awareness of speech sounds is focused on in the classroom. We need to help our learners to catch up on their sound awareness. Our second language learners need support. If we can develop speech perception skills, we are supporting development of phonological awareness, which leads to improved literacy outcomes over time, and that is our ultimate goal. To close, I leave you with one of my favorite quotes. To learn to read is to light a fire, and every syllable that is spelled out is a spark. Thank you so much for listening. If you have any questions, you are welcome to send them to me via email. Have a lovely day.